Hello everyone. Today I'm here with a project that is quite exciting for me. I had never done a radio-controlled vehicle printing before. I always had an interest in it, but I never dared to venture into a specialized field like airplanes. That was until I met Shamal, the founder of Craycle. In addition to designing some real-world airplane models, Craycle also focuses on engineering and design. It also models its own unique aircraft, and it makes them suitable for 3D printing. Currently, its library includes models designed for speed as well as those capable of high altitude and long range flights. It includes a wide range of aircraft, from those with high maneuverability to planes used for training purposes. And it continues to expand. As for me, among the models I saw, I chose the printing of the Cub-800 model because I really liked both its color and design. And for the printing of this beautiful model, I used this monster, the Snapmaker. Artisan Premium. This is not a review video, but I want to briefly talk about the device I used. A detailed review video will be coming in the following days. The Snapmaker Artisan Premium is a 3-in-1 printer. The Artisan Premium package I use includes a dual nozzle printing head, a 40-watt diode laser, and a 200-watt CNC module, such as. Switching between these modules can be done very quickly. In addition, with its 40x40 large printing area, industrial-grade rail systems, and sturdy build, it seems like a great option, especially for those who create their own projects or engineers. As I just mentioned, since this was my first time working on such a project, I was very excited. One reason for my excitement was wondering whether I would end up missing any parts. Would I be able to assemble it properly? I downloaded the files from Craycle's website and saw that everything was very simple. Everything was explained clearly. The parts list, the basic settings required for printing these parts, the motors to be used for the aircraft, electronics, information about the parts and battery is included in the file. Taking these into account, I was able to get printing from Craycle quite comfortably without asking anything. During printing, my printer did not give me any trouble. Artisan is an extremely stable and fairly quiet machine. Although it's not very fast, it can reach speeds of up to 180 millimeters per second. In fact, it can operate even faster, but the recommended maximum speed is this. Since I focused on surface quality and wanted the single wall printing layers to fuse well, I did not exceed speeds of 75 to 100 millimeters per second. I was quite satisfied with the result. In projects like these, different parts may be expected to have varying levels of lightness, heat resistance, or durability. For example, Craycle mentioned that printing the red parts you see in this project with PETG would be suitable. So why PETG? Because almost all FDM type printers can process PETG material. However, if your printer is suitable for it, you can also printing with ABS or ASA. ABS and ASA are more suitable for enclosed 3D printers. If you have a device like the Artisan, you can take advantage of its enclosure to process ABS and printing, or you can use CNC or laser features to make these parts from PVC, acrylic, or MDF. You can even use metal. Additionally, you can mark the parts and, as I did, cut a label with a laser and attach it to your model. Right now, those who have previously 3D printed radio-controlled car parts, I can imagine their eyes lighting up as they start thinking about what else can be done with equipment like CNC and laser, because these features significantly increase your production freedom. Of course, this applies not only to this topic, but to almost every project. Printing the plane was actually the easiest part of the job. This project progressively becomes more challenging. The second stage is assembly. In fact, assembling the parts together is not difficult. But to properly place the internal components and make the pre-flight adjustments, I went to Craycle. Now, I will quickly show you the assembly stages, and just like me. For those who are doing this for the first time, Cemal will occasionally share some key tips with you.
Wipe off the excess adhesive, we also spread it at the same time. That provides excellent durability to the parts. Right, what stage are we at right now? We just finished the fuselage. Now we've moved on to the wing section. There's a detail about the hinge that I want to explain here. For the wings and the tail, we always finish the hinge section first. That means we install the rudder, elevator, and aileron flaps. The reason for this is as follows. For example, let's assume we glue the wing first. The spray we apply here can put printing on the hinge slots, preventing the hinge from being installed later. That's why we will install the hinge first. There are also some small details about that. Let me show you. I always pour it onto a surface like this. That's why we use it for application. I take it from here. When I take it from here, I can control the amount better. And it's more convenient, cleaner. I took just a tiny amount. This is enough since it's TPU and it gets in between. It never comes off. Once it hardens there, if you apply too much here, since it will harden in between, it won't allow the flexible TPU filament to stretch. I start with small pieces first. I glued this one the same way. Since it's hard to pick it up from the surface, I apply it directly on top. For example, if there's excess, I remove it just a little. We need to be careful with the sanding. These are a few trials and practice. Note direction, bottom part, always bottom. When I make these sweeping motions here, the adhesive spreads inside the device, sticky, and I position each piece upright like this so that the printing doesn't shift, because we adjust that in the design. I secured it with my hand like this. I spray a very small amount from both sides.
And I'll throw it.
We're getting ready.
It was a great day and an amazing experience for me. I really wanted to fly the plane, maybe even do some flips with the drone. But they didn't give me the controls. Instead, they gave me a controller on my way home. They said, take this, go practice some simulation. Then they told me to come back. I'm practicing and I'm practicing hard. Very soon, I'll be doing a real flight. Of course, only if you want me to. If you want more videos of radio-controlled vehicles like this one, please share your suggestions with me in the comments section. If you liked the video, I'd love to make another one. You can visit Craycle's website if you're interested. Moreover, those who purchase STL will receive first a 25% discount coupon for the first 10 people and a 10% discount coupon for those after the first 10 waiting for you in the video description. Thanks to Craycle for the videos and their support, to Mekid, the founder of the Technical Workshop YouTube channel for the flight shots, and to Snapmaker, the main sponsor of the video. And of course, a big thank you to all of you watching. May your printer run smoothly and your printing be flawless. See you in the next video. Goodbye.
What are we doing now, bro? What are the final checks?
We checked the center of gravity. That's the most important thing.
If there's an error in that, the plane can go off course. We're checking the control surfaces. All power shields are active. Other than that, we're checking the engine power.
And we're ready.
All right, bro. Then I'm telling you one last time. That's it. I mean, what I want. You know how the Turkish stars fly in a straight line and then they go around it while flipping upside down and all. Smoke comes out from the back and everything. Of course, there won't be any smoke. But something like that from behind.
So you're saying stop right in the middle of the spin?
Right in the middle. Stay still. Let it spin. Something like that.
If a pilot can do it, I can do it.
Can we pull off a move like that?
We'll try, brother.
We try. All right, then. Let's get started.
I'll turn right towards the island.
Keep going.
I moved it to the back.
Let me ascend a little.
Don't. Let's get a steady shot first.
I've already taken plenty.
No, I want the long shots.
Man, I've been following you since bow turn.
All right, turn already.
Turn now.
It's turning. We're high up. Bro, I don't think it'll snap.
Forget about snapping. The battery or something else might fail. We're in a really risky spot right now.
All right, bring it down then.
The weather is stable like this.
No, bro, the landing was perfect, top-notch, nothing wrong. The cover was already broken at the clip.
It's holding the tape. If I turn my head, it feels like I'll catch the plane.
Yes, that happens when you wear the goggles.